Iñaki Avalos, you're a teacher, the new director of architecture at Harvard. You're also an advisor to a master's program at IE. You've had enormous experience in the academic field. I'm sure you've seen a lot of changes in education. Could you tell us a little about the changes that you've seen in the past 10, 20 years? And then I'd like to ask you about the future of education and what our students should be looking towards.
All of us have seen a lot of changes. I mean, I think that we were taught in a moment where modernism was still very active, especially in Spain. And in my case, I was educated in a very polytechnical tradition, which had an enormous impact in the way I understand architecture. And then we had all this period and where history became like the main, if not the only factor. And then after that, the linguistic turn, the iconic turn, and it has, I mean, so we've been seeing a continuous process of changes and sometimes with very interesting results, sometimes with more, let's say, difficult to believe in results. And we are now in a moment that, for many reasons, it has been described in many ways as not only a financial crisis in Europe, but also an ecological, cultural, and social crisis. And it's always a topic, but in this moment is quite important in terms of how do we understand for the future, how do we project the figure of the architect in the future. In this sense, I think that, I mean, I don't want to perform too eclectic now, but I think that in no one of the two traditional methods can fulfill the expectations in this moment. They're not the political tradition, not the box art. I mean, we are not just artists. We are not just like civil engineers. I mean, and we have to update the kind of background the architect has in technological terms. We have to update it enormously. And at the same time, we have to understand that this kind of technological background is not a kind of bureaucratic approach. It's not about limiting the fantasy, it's about projecting the fantasy of the architect and establishing like new ideas, new concepts to resolve the enormous amounts of problems that contemporary cities have.
It's interesting because it sounds like your approach, and from looking at your architectural work, that the idea of the synthesis, that you don't see technology as a tool, but it's part of today's culture. You don't see history as a way of just explaining, but it's the backdrop for the work that you undertake as you project, as you design. Do you think that maybe the way in the future is much more integration, or is that just a utopian idea?
It has to be integration. It has to be about integration, but it's very difficult to pretend to know about everything. So what we have to really select quite well is which kind of knowledge we are able to deal with. I mean, how can we, let's say, establish a combination of humanistic approaches and scientific approaches, how this cocktail can become, no? And how it can become more productive in social terms and in urban terms. No? And this is, for me, the key in every academia now, no? How to establish the doses of history, which kind of history, how we understand the figure of history, how much of technology we teach, which kind of technologies. It's just digital tools, it's about principles, scientific principles, is just a very practical and applied science. So these things. And what's the role of design? No? How do we really design? How do we use this information we can have as a background for our imagination, for our fantasies? I mean, this is what it is about. I mean, this is very serious. I mean, this is not about just putting things together, it's projecting them into a kind of something unexpected, something new.
And that seems to be the great challenge, but also the great opportunity of architecture, that ability to be able to, in some ways, look to the future, using tools and ideas now, but more than any other profession, projecting into the future to deal with the many complexities of society and of cities.
So, just one fact. China, 300 million people will become citizens of different urban settings in, let's say, one or two decades, more than Europe. It's brutal. The need of architecture is nowadays enormous, and the need of the architects trained to really confront the problems we have in our societies and establish new standards of quality, really project new cities that don't just care about the square meters built every year, but give a new idea of quality in life, I think is completely needed. So even if we are in a bad moment, let's say economical or cultural, we have to be very optimistic. Architecture is probably the most important profession for the future, at least for the quality of life in the future.
Iñaki Avalos, we're so lucky that you are a professor. We're thankful that you're an advisor to IE, and best of luck in the future too.
It's a great pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.